I was sincerely hoping I won't bother you with another trade union related story for a while, but it just seems that that's what's in the air right now in the games industry. The latest call came with the extraordinary events in America where ArenaNet, mostly known for their Guild of Wars franchise, fired two of their employees for their certain comments on social media. Instead of going to customer services or community managers, Guild of Wars fans approached Jessica Price, a writer on the game, with their ideas as how to improve the story. Ms. Price, someone who has been in the industry for a decade, did not wish to engage with such discussions on Twitter during her off-work time, but was surprised when this refusal was met with a ton of abuse from the Reddit head. Ms. Price and a male ArenaNet worker that jumped to his colleague's defense were both unceremoniously fired by the company, although they previously had no warnings or history of bad behavior. Personally, I see four issues here. One. No member of staff should be expected to represent that company 24/7 unless they are being paid extra and it's specifically written in their contract. Even then, the company should be expected to step in at any time when the worker feels unsafe. Two, a lot of the time such unjust firings happen, but their publicity is suppressed with non-disclosure agreements, NDAs. I can understand the need of them for protecting the content of the game, but they are increasingly being used to silence staff about their work conditions. This is a very practical campaign a games industry trade union, for instance, should really be looking into. Three, what if the worker would be spouting racist or misogynist abuse? Wouldn't we be calling them out and have them fired? This means that it's not only the off time that should be respected at the end of the day, but the content of the messages has to be taken into account too. For instance, the brilliant independent workers of Great Britain trade union have just exposed the far-right tendencies of one of the managers in charge of IWGB's black and minority ethnic members at the University of London. That should certainly be saluted. I don't think we should be giving a carte blanche to oppressive ideologies, even though they are expressed off work. Four, it is up to companies to change their culture and start convincing the fans that a happy workplace is what makes the game great. The ideal here should be creating a solidarity between the players and game creators. If such strategic plans are not the point of the bosses, then what exactly is it? Join your local Game Workers Unite group and be sure to change all of this. As for the UK chapter, they have two events coming up before the official launch in September. Stay tuned. I'm Mariam Dujugalvita. This is Left Left Up. Do give us a thumbs up. Bye-bye.